Assalamu alaikum. I am Asad Yusuf and welcome to MPT channel. Today's topic is dose volume histogram. So this is an overview. Dose volume histogram is a concept used in radiation treatment planning, introduced in 1979 by Michael Guyton. The purpose of DVH is to summarize the 3D dose distribution in graphical 2D format. A DVH is created by first determining the size of the dose bin of the histogram. Bins can be of arbitrary size, example 0 to 1 gray, 1.001 to 2 gray, 2.0001 to 3 gray, etc. Two types of DVH, differential DVH and cumulative DVH. Almost all the treatment planning system and radiotherapy have these kind of DVH. So these are the different shapes. It can be visualized in either of two ways, differential DVH or cumulative DVH. So this is a differential one and this is a cumulative one. So what happens, whatever the plan we do, it's divide the total area into the grids, a numerous number of grids, and in each grid the pixel was assigned. And this is how when you optimize the plan, the pixels are defined on each grid. So if you talk about the cubic form, it's called voxel. So it took the doses from these voxels and accumulated in a form of graph. So the differential DVH, in a differential DVH, bar or column height indicates the volume of structure receiving the dose. Bin doses are along the horizontal axis and the structural volume are on the vertical axis. The differential DVH take the appearance of typical histogram, which you already seen in the previous slides. The line always slope and start from the top, left, bottom, right. So usually a differential is used to check the difference of or heterogeneity inside the volume or inside the OAR. So and it's better to see the dose differential DVH in a spinal cord to check whether there is a hot spot in any part of the spinal cord or not. Usually the preference is a cumulative DVH, and this is what the clinician and most of the physicists understand. Cumulative DVH are overwhelmingly used and preferred over differential DVH. The DVH is a universal in the medical specialty of radiation oncology. Used clinically, usually include all the structure and the target of interest in the radiotherapy plan. Each line plotted a different color representing a different structure. The vertical axis is almost always plotted as percent volume as well. So this is a visual look. And in the cumulative DVH, it's very important to understand the concept of D minimum, D 50, D maximum, and D 98, and D 2. So these are the ICRU requirements, ICRU reporting and prescribing requirements that one has to report these doses of specific volume. And this is the difference. You can see the differential, the dose heterogeneity. The doses from 95 to 107 or 105 is shown in this way. Usually it comes straight. This is not the way it comes. It's usually straight and then a peak in the last, most of the cases. So in summary, dose volume histogram is a mathematical tool to assess the appropriateness of the given radiation therapy plan. It can be used to assess whether a plan meets desired constraint for volume of interest within a certain limitation. DVH are widely used, and understanding how they work is a basic skill of treatment planning assessment. So these are the references. And thank you very much for your time. And have a good day with this short presentation. Keep sharing.